Next up, a chance for Massachusetts' rich maritime history to unfold before your very eyes. WGBH's arts editor, Jared Bowen, takes us on a tour of a new museum on the Cape, which focuses on treasures recovered from the Whydah, which shipwrecked off Wellfleet nearly 300 years ago.
It was 1717 when a British slave ship named the Whydah, captained by pirate Black Sam Bellamy, ran headlong into a nor'easter off the coast of Cape Cod. The Whydah hit land and keeled over. All but two crew members drowned, and the sea submerged the vessel's gold and silver deep into the sand.
It was a story that every Cape Codder treasured, I believe. And I heard the story from my Uncle Bill growing up as a kid, and mermaids and chests of treasure.
Ocean explorer Barry Clifford never forgot about the Whydah as he traveled the world, searching sunken ships for treasure. In 1982, just east of Wellfleet, he discovered what he believed was debris from the Whydah. Even John F. Kennedy Jr. joined him on attempts to raise the ship, or at least parts of it.
Historically and archaeologically, it could be the only pirate ship that's ever been found.
Then, in 1985, he and his diving crew struck gold, finding this bell inscribed with the words, "The Whydah Galley, 1716.
You know, the front page of the New York Times and hundreds of millions of dollars worth of treasure. I had more friends than I knew what to do with all of a sudden.
The courts ruled the riches were legally his. And over the next 30 years, Clifford planned the Whydah Pirate Museum, now open in West Yarmouth, Massachusetts.
We really want to focus on kids and getting them to take a second look at history.
The museum shows what life was like on the Whydah, gaming tokens to pass the time, tools to keep the ship together, a toilet to find relief, and yes, an overflowing treasure chest.
The Whydah is the only authentic pirate treasure in the world.
Getting the loot ready for display takes time. Conservators like Chris McCourt first x-rays these concretions to find out what's inside. Then, with a dental pick and toothbrush, he spends about a week extracting gold coins, silver buttons, and more.
So this is like cement. So anything that's been trapped inside here that's been around that iron object is going to be protected and locked up in these time capsules.
How do you know when it's a concretion versus a rock or something underneath the surface?
A lot of times we work with zero visibility or very little, so we'll feel this maybe before we see it, and it doesn't feel like a rock.
Among the some 150 armed men aboard when the ship wrecked was a child.
It was this very rebellious young boy named John King, who threatened his mother and joined the pirates.
His short life was preserved through a size 6 shoe, silk stocking, and leg bone, a harsh piece of maritime history presented amid cases of African jewels and bags of booty.
We all know we did the right thing, you know, keeping this together, and especially where it means so much.
With thousands of concretions left to take apart and plans for an 18th century pirate village, the museum has only just set sail. Jared Bowen, WGBH News.